Mr. Wake, I know you have more pages of the manuscript on you.
You don't understand how vital these pages are. They're the only way I can know what's coming.
You're not the only one trying to solve this. This is our job.
Okay. Here. Now, this is all I have. Be careful with them.
Inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery, Saga had seen Wake's fabled clicker for the first time, in the hands of the cult of the tree. A cultist stared at her. She drew her weapon.
He's scratched when he looks like me, but he can change into this other form.
But your double edited it into a horror story that's now changing reality, taking over people.
The cult of the tree has the clicker Wake told me about. They're a part of all this. Think, Saga. It's all on the page. The clicker, the cult. Okay, I'll head to Watery and find this trailer. Casey, you stay here and keep an eye on Mr. Wake.
Got it.
No, you need me there.
No dice, pal. This is an FBI investigation, and I don't see a badge on that flannel.
You wrote these pages in the dark place. So why are we finding them here?
I think I wrote them. I remember writing an endless amount of pages. When this happened before, the pages were being sent from the dark place to help me. Maybe the same thing is happening here.
That's all for now, Mr. Wake. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hi, welcome.
Okay, past favorite Deerfest floats. Go.
The yarn puppet monstrosity.
The stuffed moose and squirrels one.
No, thank you. Those beady dead marble eyes still give me nightmares.
So who's in for a bet this year? $100 says there will be at least one fender bender between the floats.
For that amount of money, you'll cause it yourself.
Yeah, I'm not taking that wager. Too many opportunities for interference.
Washington's best coffee-themed amusement park.
All of our attractions are family-friendly and available to children of all ages, just like our coffee.
So, take a sip of our Oh Dear Diner organic coffee and let the adventure begin! Hold on for dear life on the Espresso Express! Soak in some local history at the Huatari Well, where two serial killers once hid the disemboweled bodies of their murder victims.
It's not haunted. No.
Come join Mocha Moose and the goats at our amusement park petting zoo. Just don't share your coffee with the goats. Seriously, stop feeding our goats coffee.
Seriously, it's not a moose.
Take in amazing views from the slow roaster Ferris wheel.
I can almost see the watery lighthouse trailer park.
This is so much fun. And finish off at our beautiful gift shop where seniors and children under 10 receive a 9% discount on keychains and propane tanks. Welcome to Coffee World. We guarantee you'll jaw a great time.
This is the third time I've requested something be done about the TV in my room. It keeps going on by itself. It's keeping me awake all night.
Yes, sir, I'm terribly sorry for that. We've called a professional electrician. In the meantime, have you tried unplugging the TV for the night?
Oh, there's an idea, Einstein. Why don't I just get rid of everything I'm paying for in that room while I'm at it? Sleep on the floor. Go to the toilet in the corner. Hey, I'm not unplugging it. You're fixing it.
Of course, sir.
It doesn't budge.
Hello?
Tammy tapped her pen on her notebook. Alan Wake had ridden this same ferry into town when he arrived. This was his entry into Bright Falls. His first steps across the threshold. She wrote that down. She always found it helpful to walk in the victim's shoes, do what they did, see what they saw. It added great color to the book. Tammy felt raindrops on her face. God, again? She pulled up her hood. The rain just kept coming. She missed New York. So far, this hadn't been the simple research trip she pictured. First the incident at the lake, then the fight with Ed. It's not surprising tempers got hot. They were both on edge after what had happened. Tammy had said some things she regretted. She looked out over the harbor. A chill passed through her. She hoped Ed wouldn't do anything stupid. Ed hadn't been the same since his latest show had closed. This wasn't the first time one of his productions had shuttered early. Scathing social commentary in a one-act play wasn't exactly filling seats. When Tammy told him she was taking a research trip to Bright Falls, he decided to tag along. Ed told her he wanted to find inspiration. Really, he just wanted a break from the city. But it was true that he certainly needed to find something. A voice, a direction, an idea. Something authentic to himself. Ed knew he couldn't keep using Tammy's money to fund his playwriting. After the argument with Tammy, Ed stormed out of the diner and drove their rental car back to Cauldron Lake to prove a point. Now standing in the dark woods, the sun hidden by the trees, Ed wished he could remember what that point was. Something about masculinity. He cursed at himself and turned to go. Suddenly, he was blinded by a light in his face. Voices shouted and hands pushed him to the ground. Ed struggled in vain.
Welcome back, and boy, do we have some breaking news.
Hello, and welcome to
Thank you.
It's not opening.
Is there anything else I can help you with, sir? Would you like a complimentary dinner tonight?
Well, that almost makes up for the ineptitude of this place.
I'm glad to hear it.
Very special guest today on the program. It's artisan cuckoo clock designer Terry Feldman. Terry, how are we today?
Hey there, Pat. Doing just fine. I'm a super big fan of the show. What a treat to be on with you today.
Mercedo won't roll over on the issues.
able to escape. A dark presence had stopped me. I had seen the title page of another manuscript, Return. I didn't remember writing it, but it felt familiar, important. I had to find it. The plot board was empty again. I needed a new draft, back at the beginning, but closer to my goal.
The writer. Maybe he was a victim. The cult, using his words.
I would write a new draft of initiation to reach Parliament Tower using another murder site. Scratch was reaching out from the dark place to get Alice. She was out, but still in danger. Forgotten. I knew how this worked now. I could take control, no more surprises.
What demons he wrestles with in the dark hours of the night. Together with our house band, the divine old gods of Asgard, we have created something special. The song is called Herald of Darkness, but I like to call this next segment the story of the journey of Alan Wake, the musical. Just do what we always do. We'll chat, but instead of talking, we'll sing it.
You grew up nice and sheltered with mama's pretty stories and your own made up fury.
And mama gave me a magic clicker. Well, yes, I think it's true and fair to say.
We'll be right back. encounter stories early on.
My dreams would light up my imagination.
And you had nightmares night and day.
Yeah, but with the clicker, I chased those frights away.
Who, you?
So true.
So here.
Chilling thrillers of hard-boiled killers became bestsellers. It was all too much. I had to get away.
for it to ruin my life that way.
You just say you lived a jaded lie.
Dark shades could never save the day.
So sad,
but true.
Fire in the nightmares, dark
No escape. same before him, and maybe they'd be happy once again. Just one shot, one more chance for him to save their marriage. Away from the city, a romantic getaway.